Well, good morning. Today I'm joined by Powell Police Chief Gary Best, Auglaize County Sheriff Al Solomon, Ohio State Highway Patrol Lieutenant Tony Bradshaw, and BCI Special Agent and Ohio CART Coordinator Larry McCoy. We're here to talk about the safety of our kids in a law enforcement effort to help find them in the horrible event that they are missing and are believed to be in immediate danger. On average, 44 children are reported missing in Ohio every single day. In the most alarming cases, an Amber Alert is actually triggered. Amber Alerts, however, are really pretty rare. Only 8 Amber Alerts were issued in all of last year. But it does happen. That means a child has been possibly kidnapped. When Amber Alert goes out, it means a child has possibly been kidnapped and is in immediate danger. The Child Abduction Response Team, or CART, was designed for such cases. CART teams that have operated around Ohio since 2006 have been the joint effort, really, of local law enforcement agencies working together. In 2012, when his 11-year-old stepdaughter vanished, a man in Russell's Point, Ohio, Logan County, reported her missing. Nearly a dozen members of the Central Ohio CART team were called to action. A reverse 911 call went out to residents within a 5-mile area of a missing child's home. A few minutes later, a person reported he had spotted the girl. She was found unharmed, sleeping behind a fast food restaurant. She stayed out all night because of a family conflict. That's how CART works, and it does in fact work. Today, we're announcing the building upon CART's success. We're suggesting a new model for CART in the state of Ohio. People here today represent the groups that have worked on this new CART model for the past 21 months. The Attorney General's Bureau of Criminal Investigation, the Ohio Association of Chiefs of Police, the Buckeye Sheriff's Association, and the Ohio State Highway Patrol. People from these groups are part of the CART Steering Committee. Many of them are here today. Let me introduce Lieutenant Jim Crawford, the Coshocton County Sheriff's Office, Chief Bruce Jamison, Piqua Police Department, Jeffrey Hill, the CART Project Director, Cynthia Peterman, BCI, as well as I want to introduce Bob Cornwell, Buckeye Sheriffs, and Tom Maurer, the Team Adam Consultant with the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. All these individuals have certainly played a major role in bringing us today to where we are. Let me explain how the new CART model works. The new CART model begins with a CART coordinator. That person identifies area resources, such as investigators, victim advocates, air and water assets, search dogs, search and rescue personnel. All of these assets that would be needed in the case of a CART activation. The CART coordinator would assist the incident commander, who would be in charge of the search for the missing child and the investigation of the criminal case. So what we envision is a CART coordinator in that area, who had been pre-designated, would assist that local department, and the incident commander who had been assigned to this incident, who would be in charge of the search for the missing child. The local police chief or sheriff would make the call when CART should be activated. But a general suggested guideline includes a missing, high-risk, endangered, and or abducted child under 18 years of age. However, as I mentioned, the ultimate decision is made locally. Our model in the past has been to assemble a team with specific people doing specific jobs. But some people have moved on to other jobs or retired. We believe the number of CART teams has actually, in the state of Ohio, gotten significantly smaller. CART teams that are still existing today are welcome, of course, to continue operating under the current model if that's working for them. Let me now introduce Powell Police Chief Gary Vest. The chief is a champion of CART and was instrumental in bringing the program to Ohio when it started in 2006. He approached our office to revitalize this effort. It was his idea to do it, and we started doing it after we had the conversation with the chief. Chief.
Thank you, Attorney General Mike DeWine. I first want to again publicly thank Attorney General Mike DeWine for engaging us in this process. It is, when we first learned of the CART strategies, which really is a Department of Justice program that's been funded and provides a lot of trainings, Attorney General's office took on also to aid us in the training process so that we could not only use federally funded training, but individual training, working with them and through our Ohio Chiefs of Police Association. The unique thing about the strategies that we are taking on today is that we've always had good law enforcement agencies, good police departments, chiefs, sheriffs, working with the highway patrol and local relationships. And when a child's missing, everybody knows that we're going to come out and help. Okay, if there's any conflict in the world between one agency or one office, one place, that all disappears when a child is missing. So that wasn't the challenge that we faced with our change. The challenge we faced is that coordinated response. And what the Attorney General's office is really bringing to the table for us is a structure that allows the local sheriff, the local police chief, the local jurisdiction to coordinate those responses, have that advanced plan before we get there. Because not every county has a victim advocate that can respond immediately. Some of our offices are strained for personnel. This is a force multiplier. It allows the agencies to get all the resources together and leads the leadership right where it belongs with the local sheriff or the local police chief in that jurisdiction. But it encourages them best practices. It provides crime analysts, victim advocates, search and rescue, all these resources that we don't use every day. Not anything is more demanding than having a child abducted. Statistics say that if death is the outcome, 75% of the children are killed within the first 3 hours. When you look at it from a local law enforcement perspective, we would love to have resources fly in from Washington, D.C. or anywhere in the world. But the boots on the ground are going to be the local agencies working together within the county and the adjoining counties. And we need, in order to get that uniform response, we needed this kind of structure to make it happen. Thank you, Attorney General.